In your headlines, Ministry of Health encourages community to get tested for COVID-19, vaccine soon to be mandated for U.S. visa application, and three men in police custody after armed robbery in Grand Turk. Hello, Turks and Caicos. Thank you for joining us for another edition of Newswatch. It's Thursday, September 2nd, 2021. I'm Malik Harvey. The real news starts right now. Testing plays a key role in our efforts to contain and mitigate the COVID-19 pandemic by identifying infected individuals to help prevent further person-to-person transmission of COVID-19. The Minister of Health says he is encouraging persons to get tested for the deadly virus. Latoya Walken reports.
No country knows the total number of people infected with COVID-19. All we know is the infection status of those who have been tested. All those who have a lab-confirmed infection are counted as confirmed cases. This means that the count of confirmed cases depend on how much a country actually tests. The Minister of Health, Honorable Jamel Robinson, in an interview with Newswatch, says that it is important to know your COVID-19 status.
Having more persons being tested to know their status is very important as a strategy as well, and that's something we're going to try to focus on to make it more readily available, as well as encourage people to be tested, especially those that are unvaccinated, because at the end of the day, even if you get the COVID-19 virus, you can be asymptomatic. So you being in a healthy state or feeling healthy doesn't mean you don't have the virus. So persons are encouraged to know their status. And persons who are vaccinated, you can also do the testing as well, just to make sure that in the off chance that you are a breakthrough case, that you're not putting others in jeopardy, including your family and their loved ones.
Honorable Robinson also highlighted that community testing is being carried out by the Ministry of Health as a continued effort to contain the spread of COVID-19.
We have community testing, which persons can go into their private medical facility at certain times and be tested, because we set up one from March 29th, 2021, an MOU where that is available, plus the government does their community testing as well. I have that apparatus. But of course, with contact tracing, right? So if there is a positive case, the contact tracing team will have to discuss with that person to find out all the persons that might have been in their circle within a time frame, so we could get an idea of who might have been impacted, and then you trace them and test them. So you quarantine the persons and get them tested as well. So testing takes place.
It was also pointed out that travelers should be aware that there are no government quarantine facilities in place should a visitor test positive for the virus.
There aren't any national quarantine facilities available at this particular time. So persons would have to quarantine in place. So if you're a tourist, you would end up quarantining at your hotel in the particular room away from others until you recover, until you can provide a negative test some 7 to 10 days later.
Reporting for PTV Newswatch, I'm Latoya Walken.
As of October 1st, the CDC will require all age-appropriate applicants for U.S. visas worldwide to be vaccinated in order to be considered for the U.S. travel entry document. Here's more.
As of October 1st, the Center for Disease Control and Prevention will require all immigrant visa recipients, persons 12 years and older, to be fully vaccinated before being considered for grant. This is for persons looking to lawfully live and work in the United States. U.S. Embassy officials say applicants will need to present their original vaccination card and a color copy of their card to the panel physician at the time of their appointment, which means that both jabs should have already been administered and the 28-day period passed. Officials say the requirement applies to both adjustment of status applicants in the U.S. and immigrant visa applicants applying for green cards abroad at U.S. embassies and consulates. The COVID-19 vaccine has been added to the already hefty list of vaccinations required to attain lawful residency in the United States, which include polio, tetanus, rubella, hepatitis A, and B vaccinations. Hence, after October 1st, green card applicants who attend their medical examination without proof of full COVID-19 vaccination will likely experience delays with processing unless clearly exempt under one of the blanket waiver categories, which include persons younger than the lowest age limit for available vaccines in their jurisdiction and persons who can document a medical contradiction. The new vaccination policy is not a requirement for persons seeking non-immigrant visas like tourist and student visa applications.
It's time for a quick break. We have your crime report when we return.
This is a reminder that all PTV service accounts are due on the first day of each month. Accounts should be brought up to date by the 28th of the month to avoid disruption in service. Payments may be made on our office at Stubbs Diamond Plaza Providence Jollies, Midas Plaza North Caicos, and Airport Road in South Caicos. Payments may also be made online using Scotiabank, CIBC First Caribbean Bank, and Royal Bank of Canada. Please allow 3 business days for online payments to be processed. We thank you for your cooperation.
Welcome back to Newswatch. 3 men are in police custody after an armed robbery occurred at the business establishment in the nation's capital. Here's the latest in your crime report.
Police officers on the island of Grand Turk are investigating a robbery that took place on Tuesday, August 31st, 2021. According to an official report, 2 masked men wearing all black, one armed with a machete, while the other suspect held a gun, entered the business establishment and demanded money. The suspect stole an undisclosed amount of cash and a purse containing a cellular phone and other personal items. The official release also noted that reports to the police control room stated that around 12 p.m., a bar and restaurant located along Front Street was robbed of cash and other items. 3 men are in custody in relation to this incident. Police say further information will be provided as the investigation progresses. Also in your crime update, on August 27, 2021, police authorities recovered a large quantity of ammunition at the Providenciales Airport en route to Grand Turk on an inter-Caribbean flight. While details remain sketchy as to how the discovery happened, Newswatch can confirm that one person is in custody. Now, information circulated quickly on social media with details attached to what appeared to be a suitcase with a contact name and number. Police officials noted that an investigation has also been launched into how that video was circulated. While investigations are ongoing, Newswatch will update you should more information become available. Reporting for PTV Newswatch, I'm Latoya Walker.
We'll be right back when we return your sports authority and weather forecast.
In order to auto-scan your PTV set-top box, you need to follow these basic steps. Turn on your television and set-top box. Press menu on the remote control. Choose installation and press OK. Enter password, press 0000. Choose auto-search and press OK. Go down to start search and press OK. Choose yes and press OK. The box will start searching for channels until process bar reach 100%. Click on exit and data will be saved. Click on exit again to continue enjoying the PTV experience. Thank you for supporting the PTV network.
Welcome back to Newswatch. Here's the latest in your sports authority and weather forecast. The TCI Cycling Federation is closing its season in style. We spoke to Carl Isaac, the secretary of the TCI Cycling Federation, who told us that they have the national championships coming up on the 11th of September and a few other events as well.
And the national championship road race, which is going to be on Sunday, September 12th. And the third and last race for the regular season is going to be on the Youth Day, which is set Friday, September 24th, which is going to be strictly for the categories of the under 23s, juniors, and cadets.
The season typically runs from the 1st of January to the 30th of September.
With the month of October, we will have our tour of Turks and Caicos. And we normally have November and December, and you can say part of January as well, because there's only one race in January. Those 3 months is where the cyclists would, you know, recover, you know, from a year, you know, nine months of racing, and just for them to rest and then, you know, to prepare back up for the next season.
The Federation has had its share of challenges, however. This affected the youth races most.
Well, the thing about it is that since due to the pandemic is that our season has been very disrupted this year. And even with the regulation of the COVID protocols, way in terms of group gathering and so forth, is that we have not concentrated in terms of on the youth races for this year. And then because there is a taken consideration, the concern of the parents in terms of having their children exposed. So we have only had races in terms of the adults, and the adults meaning anybody above 23 years old.
For your sports authority, I'm Ali Carvey. Here's your weather forecast for September 3rd, 2021. Grand Turk on Friday, mostly cloudy skies, high 85, low 81, winds east-southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. South Caicos on Friday, mostly cloudy skies, high 85, low 80, winds east-southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. North and Mill Caicos on Friday, partly cloudy skies, high 85, low 80, winds east-southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Parrot and Pine Key on Friday, partly cloudy skies, high 85, low 81, winds east-southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. And on Providence Islands on Friday, partly cloudy skies, high 85, low 81, winds east-southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. And for your sunrise and sunset, sunrise 6:34 a.m., sunset 7:05 p.m. And for your high tide and low tide, high tide 5:34 a.m., 5:57 p.m. And for your low tide, 11:31 a.m., 11:31 p.m. And for your hurricane outlook, for the North Atlantic, Caribbean Sea, and the Gulf of Mexico, special tropical weather outlook issued to introduce a new system located to the east-southeast of the Cabo Verde Islands. Satellite imagery and recent satellite wind data indicate that a low-pressure area has formed about 300 miles east-southeast of the southernmost Cabo Verde Islands, and that the associated showers and thunderstorms show signs of organization. Some additional development could occur during the next 12 to 24 hours as the low moves generally westward at about 15 miles per hour. After that time, conditions are expected to become less conducive for development. The National Hurricane Center is issuing advisories on Hurricane Larry, located over the eastern tropical Atlantic, several hundred miles west-southwest of the southernmost Cabo Verde Islands. A small area of low pressure over northeastern Nicaragua is producing disorganized shower and thunderstorm activity. A portion of the low's circulation could move over the Gulf of Honduras on Friday. However, development there, if any, is expected to be slow to occur. And that's it for your weather forecast and hurricane outlook. We'll be right back for more Newswatch.
This is a reminder that all PTV service accounts are due on the first day of each month. Accounts should be brought up to date by the 28th of the month to avoid disruption in service. Payments may be made on our office at Stubbs Diamond Plaza, Providence Jollies, Mides Plaza, North Caicos, and Airport Road in South Caicos. Payments may also be made online using Scotiabank, CIBC First Caribbean Bank, and Royal Bank of Canada. Please allow 3 business days for online payments to be processed. We thank you for your cooperation.
Welcome back to Newswatch. The TCI Writers Society has officially launched its first ever writing competition under the theme, The Best Story, with a few prizes up for grabs. Find out how you can get involved. More details in this next story. Newswatch has received more details as it relates to the upcoming first annual story writing competition, The Best Story. The competition officially started on September 1st and will end on November 12th. The content is expected to be a one-of-a-kind creation and submitted in a timely manner before the deadline. Primary age participants must enter the fairy tale and fable category. Their pieces will be limited to 500 words max. Middle schoolers are able to enter the folklore, fable, adventure, and mystery categories. This age range has a minimum of 1,200 words. High schoolers 16 to 18 can enter any category, 1,500 words max. Everyone else can write on any category, inclusive of fiction, comedy, romance, sci-fi, fantasy, novel, mystery, adventure, political, gospel, folklore, and fairy tale. All stories must touch on four cultural values of the Turks and Caicos Islands, such as food, culture, family, and recreation. To enter, participants must complete the application form on the Society's website at www.tciwriterssociety.org. Reporting for PTV Newswatch, I'm Ali Carvey.
So many interesting stories have emerged this week, but here's another one that made this edition of Newswatch.
On August 12th, the government of the Turks and Caicos Islands announced that effective September 1st, 2021, all tourists over the age of 16 years are required to be fully vaccinated to enter the TCI. Acting on information received, the Chambers of Commerce prepared an economic analysis of the potential impacts of a vaccine requirement for tourists to the territory. Through their data collection, the estimated impact of this policy is that there will be 52,210 fewer tourists for the September-December 2021 tourism period, totaling the overall economic impact an estimated $96 million. Now, the report highlighted three areas as follows: high vaccinated rates in elderly. Chamber statistics showed 82% of persons 65 to 74 years old are vaccinated, along with 78% of persons 75 and older. Persons over 65 years represent more than 23% of the total U.S. population. And unfortunately, these persons are traveling at vastly lower rates than younger persons. The Chamber said this is due to the increased risk of COVID-19 in elderly persons, and as such, they have postponed their trip. The second determining factor, low vaccinated rates in young adults. According to the Chambers, the Turks and Caicos is a popular destination for families, in which they highlighted Beaches Turks and Caicos all-inclusive resort as the largest resort. As of 13th of August 2021, only 42.1% of persons that's 16 to 17 years old are fully vaccinated. Chambers says that the data is not much better for those 18 to 24 years old, where it is only 45.2%. Thus, the majority of persons traveling with children who are 16 to 24 years old will be unable to vacation in the Turks and Caicos Islands. And the third factor, mixed vaccination families. The issue is that because all persons in a travel group must be vaccinated, simply having one person who can't means that the entire group is likely to cancel. The Chambers noted that it is not accurate to simply look at the overall vaccination rate of adults 18 and older, which is 62%, and assume that 62% of U.S. persons are eligible to visit. Due to the fact that some will have one person in their group or family who is not fully vaccinated. The 62% figure is very much a best case scenario, and real world statistics will depress this eligible number of travelers. In a previous interview with Newswatch, the Minister of Health, Honorable Jamel Robinson, speaking on the new measures in place, noted that the protocols will not severely affect the economy.
So for our risk management strategy, where we are at this point, we believe it's best to ensure that only vaccinated visitors can come into the TCI, which doesn't, in my belief, severely impact our ability to still draw tourists to come into the TCI. So our economy should be in a position where we can still function, in addition to still encourage people to become vaccinated, because we have one of the highest vaccination rates in the world, really, at over 68% of the adult population being vaccinated. So all of that helps to better our risk profile when it comes to dealing with COVID. So again, while the vaccine might not be perfect per se, and it can't eliminate the threat against the Delta variant, it surely gives us a better chance as individuals and as a group to be able to respond and fight against COVID-19 here in the Turks and Caicos.
Well, that's a wrap for today's Newswatch. Join us again tomorrow and every weekday at 6:30 p.m. for more Newswatch, and connect with us by visiting our website at www.ptvatci.com. Until next time, I'm Malik Harvey signing out.